The British Isles are both beautiful and rugged in equal measure. A land of breathtaking landscapes, from dramatic coastlines to rugged mountains. With its stunning beaches, wildlife populations, and ancient monuments which offer a glimpse into our incredible history. Join us as we explore our British Isles, the places that call to our hearts, and share a time of pure joy in our own lives. Join us on our adventures as we go into the wild. After a 5-hour drive from our home in Durham to Glen Etive, it was our plan to wild camp in Arney, followed by an early morning swim in one of the pools of River Etive. Arney is the name of our VW campervan, as it's a Cyberdyne Systems Model T 6.1. The mountains and weather here make for an unbelievable, mystical and otherworldly atmosphere. Although the Glen provided a quiet night's sleep, sadly, time and weather were against us as we had a very tight schedule. But we did have time to pop up the drone to capture this ageless Highland landscape. Glencoe runs east-west and is frequently overhung by cloud and rain. With its steep mountains on either side, its hidden rivers, waterfalls and valleys, they provide for an unbelievable atmospheric quality. As we head west along the A82, I spot a parking space adjacent to Glencoe Falls, and I couldn't resist the opportunity to capture some footage of the scenic waterfall. After any heavy rainfall, the water thunders down here, but today it was more of a delightful tumble, revealing a series of narrow pools.
Incredible to see coming across all of them people up there, people walking to get up there.
By the time we arrive at Ballyhoolish, the sun has finally broken through, and the conditions look very favourable to paddleboard across to a group of small uninhabited islands on Loch Leven. One of the islands, Eileen Mund, is the site of a 7th century chapel built by St. Fintan Mundus and the site of a graveyard once used by the Stuarts of Ballyhoolish, the MacDonalds of Glencoe and the Camerons of Callart. A smaller island, Eileen na Comhairle, is known as the Isle of Discussion, where, for hundreds of years, arguing members of the MacDonald clan would settle disputes. Needless to say, we have no intentions to go ashore on either island, not least in case we disturb any nesting birds.
Incredible. Look at that. I found some archaeology. Lovely glass jar. Could be Victorian, could be a few years old. Certainly looks it. Look at the marine growth on there. Just lying there on the riverbed. Sorry, just lying there on the seabed, trapped under a big stone. I'm gonna put it back. So those little creatures deserve to live. I radius on the bottom. So listen, this is absolutely incredible. What a splendid location. And I challenge anybody in the world to find a better place to paddleboard and then jump off and go and do some snorkeling in the world. It's just incredible. Glencoe, stunning scenery, beautiful clear water. The marine life is just everywhere. Just stunning. So there you go, guys, that's a challenge. Go and find somewhere better than this. I dare you, I challenge you.
After our exhilarating time in Loch Leven, we relocate to Kentallen, a small village settlement located just off the Argyll coastal route leading from Ballachulish to Oban. Situated on the shores of Loch Linnhe, Kentallen was formed around the former Oban to Fort William railway line. It was my intention to undertake a solo shore dive here. At this spot, the seabed is littered by collapsed wooden stanchions and twisted metalwork from an old steamer pier. Kentallen steamer pier was once an important, albeit short-lived, interchange for travellers between Loch Eber and Argyll. The Oban to Fort William David McBrain Shipping Company operated steamers which called here. There was a pier charge of 5 pence per passenger. This particular site is popular with divers who explore a vertical wall which runs parallel to the shoreline. It starts around 12 metres deep and bottoms out at around 34 metres. Given that I was by myself, I was more than happy to pootle about at around 8 metres and enjoy the excellent visibility and marvel at the marine life in some comfort. smile. Red hot, warmest weather I've ever climbed up Ben Nevis. Yay. Now it was a real hard pull up that first section out of Tolundi through them woods, really humid because of the heat. We've had a lot of rain recently, so very warm. But I think we're about a quarter of the way up. Another 6 hours to go before we get to the summit. After capturing the splendour of Alt Am Huilin, which descends from the northern slopes of Ben Nevis, we retrace our steps to pick up the steep trail up to a series of cairns before then descending slightly to the CMD Arête. The trail here isn't always obvious and you have to really concentrate not to wander off it. The weather is warm with virtually no wind, making really ideal conditions, and the sun isn't due to set until around 10:17 p.m. We have a wonderful window of fine weather and daylight ahead of us.
So that was a brutal ascent, really steep. Just kept going on and on and on. We're still not quite there, but just across the valley. Hopefully you can see there. There's Ben Nevis, that's where we're gonna go. Just turn the camera around. Just make out there. So the route we're gonna take takes us along that bit there, that thin ledge. That's the scary bit. That's what makes it all worthwhile, a little bit of fear. So we're gonna go around there, up to the summit, then come down via the zigzags, down to the lock, and I'll probably come down the little track. Just might make it out there if I zoom in. A little track, and then follow the valley back out, all the way down to Fort William, which is right down there.
Still don't even think we're halfway.
That's gonna be halfway.
We're a third.
Thank you.
Incredible. Lost for words. Absolutely stunning.
For us, the CMD Arête is not a technically challenging scramble, as we are familiar with such terrain. Though it is classified as a grade 1, meaning no specialist equipment is needed. On a perfect day like today, it was less scary than either striding a sharp edge in the Lake District. Sam, as fearless as ever, insisted on keeping to the very top of the ridge, rather than dropping off and using the side path.
Crampons. Jesus, it's never ending. No wind.
Am I in a video?
Yeah.
On reflection, we found the ridge itself a lot of fun, but the perfect conditions had a lot to do with that. Though on occasions we did have to use our feet and hands to cross a few of the more nerve-jangling sections. And as we all know, Scottish peaks can be exposed to extremely challenging weather conditions with strong winds, restrictive visibility and freezing temperatures. My advice to anyone thinking about undertaking this ridge walk is to wait for that fine weather window and those long daylight hours. Our walk took 13 hours. Also, on a warm day like today, take extra water or even chlorine tablets to top up from one of the mountain streams. You'll regret it if you don't.
Finally.
I didn't know you could throw snowballs.
Don't get...